Welcome to all to the second lecture of electromagnetic field theory. In the last class, we have studied the basics of electromagnetic vectors. In that, we have studied vectors, scalars, and dot product of vectors, cross product of vectors, triple product of vectors, and also we have studied what are the divergence, gradient, and curl of a vector. So today we shall continue after first what are the terms used in the electromagnetic theory. So basic terms, contains the basic terms, basic laws of and theorems, and Maxwell's equation. So we should know before going to the electromagnetic field theory what is current. It is defined as the rate of flow of charge and the unit is ampere. Next is the current density. It is the current passing through a surface area S and given by J bar is equal to I by S ampere per meter square, and also J bar is equal to sigma E bar is called Ohm's law. Next, if you want to find the force between two charges with magnitude Q1 and Q2 and the distance of separation is R, then force is directly proportional to the Q1 and Q2 and inversely proportional to the distance between them. Here the proportional constant K is given by 1 by 4 pi epsilon. Here epsilon is a permittivity. It is given by epsilon not into epsilon r, where epsilon r is equal to 1 for air and epsilon naught is equal to 8.854 into 10 raised to minus 12 Farad meter. So next we will define what is electric field intensity. It is defined as force per unit charge. If the two charges are placed at a distance of r, one is having magnitude Q1 and another is having unit charge, then the force experienced is given by E bar is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon R square R bar, where we will get F bar is equal to E bar into Q bar. So next, what is flux? When a charge is placed at some point, then the flux lines are coming out from the positive charge and they are going inside to the negative charge. The number of flux lines coming out is called the flux, and we will define the flux density, the number of flux lines passing through a surface S. Suppose surface is a spherical coordinate, space sphere, then D bar is equal to 5 by S, the surface area is equal to 4 pi R square, is given by Q by 4 pi R square. Therefore, we will get the relation between D bar and E bar is equal to, D bar is equal to epsilon E bar. Next, we will see what is the work done on the charge. This is given by small work done is equal to minus F bar dot dl bar, but F bar is equal to minus Q E bar dot dl bar against the field. Therefore, W is given minus Q, moving the charge from 2 to 1 against the field E bar dot dl bar. So next, we will define potential or voltage. It is the work done in moving a unit positive charge Q is equal to 1 from infinity to a particular point at a distance R. Therefore, V is given by minus of integration from 1 to infinity E bar dot dl bar. Next, potential difference. It is the work done in moving a unit positive charge from one point to the another against the field E bar. Therefore, V1 is given by integration from 1 to 2 E bar dot dl bar. So next, here in the electromagnetic field theory, we are using the del operator del. It is partial derivative along three axes, dou by dou x a x bar plus dou by dou y a y bar plus dou by dou z a z bar. By using the del, we can define divergence of d bar. Delta d bar is called the divergence. In Cartesian coordinate system, it is given by dou by dou x dx, dou by dou y dy, dou by dou z dz, where d bar is equal to dx ax bar plus dy ay bar plus dz dz. Next, we will define the line charge, surface charge, volume charge densities. Line charge density is represented by rho L. It is given by small charge by small length. So when the line is having some positive charges, then Q is given by integration of rho L into dl. Similarly, surface charge density rho S is given by dq by ds. Then dq is small charge, ds is small area. Therefore, q is given by rho S into ds. Volume charge density rho V is defined as dq by dv, where dv is a differential volume and dq is small charge. Therefore, q is given by rho V into dv. Next, similar to electric field intensity, magnetic field intensity S bar. When the current is flowing in a conductor, field is developed around it called S bar. S bar unit is ampere per meter. And also when the current is flowing, the flux is flowing across the line or surrounding the line. It is called magnetic flux. And length of magnetic flux is given by B bar dot B S ds bar Weber. Flux density B bar, it is defined as flux passing through in area S. B is equal to d phi by ds bar is equal to phi by S. And B bar is equal to mu S bar is the relation between B and H, where mu is equal to permeability is given by mu naught mu r, where mu r is equal to 1 in air and mu naught is equal to 4.2 10 raised to minus 7. So, already we have defined line charge density. So, we will solve one problem on the line charge density. Suppose a charge is distributed on x-axis having line charge density 3x square micro coulomb per meter. Find the total charge over the length 10 meter. So, it is given rho L is equal to 3x square micro coulomb per meter and L is equal to 10 meter. Therefore, Q is equal to integration of rho L dl. Here, dl is only dx, dy, dz are 0. Therefore, we will get 3x cube by 3. X is equal to 10, we will get 3x cube by 3 is given by 1000 micro coulomb. So, next problem, find the total charge inside a volume with rho V is equal to 10 z square e raised to minus pi 9 x sin pi y coulomb per meter cube. The volume is defined between minus 2 to 2 in x axis, 0 to 1 in y axis, 3 to 4 in z axis. Here given rho V is equal to 10 z square e raised to minus 0.1 x sin pi coulomb per meter square. Consider this differential volume in Cartesian coordinate system, dv is equal to dx divided dz, and using the formula q is equal to volumetric integral rho V dy. Apply these limits 3 to 4 for z, y is equal to 0 to 1, x is equal to minus 2 to, and integrate and substitute the value, you will get 316.162 coulomb. So next, we will define Gauss law. We know that d bar is equal to d phi by ds, it is also same as dq by ds. Therefore, q is given by surface integral of d bar dot ds bar. But q is equal to rho v dv. Equate equation number 1 and 2, we will get d bar dot ds bar is equal to rho v dv. But del dot d bar is equal to rho v, that is called Gauss line point form. It's actually we'll get 4 in 3, we'll get surface integral of d bar dot ds bar is equal to volume integral of divergence of d bar dv. So next one is Stokes theorem. It is given by line integral of S bar dot dl bar is equal to surface integral of curl of S bar dot ds bar. It can be proved like that. Proof. We know that I is equal to S bar dot dl bar, but I is also equal to j bar dot ds bar. Equation number 1 and 2, we will get S bar dot dl bar is equal to surface integral of j bar dot ds bar, but j bar is equal to curl of S bar. Therefore, here we will get line integral of S bar dot dl bar is equal to surface integral of curl of S bar dot ds bar. Next one is Ampere circuit law. It defines the line integral of a magnetic field intensity S bar around a closed path is exactly equal to the direct current enclosed by the path. The mathematical expression of Ampere circuit law is in line integral of S bar dot L bar is equal to I. Proof: let us consider a long straight conductor carrying a current I placed along Z axis as shown in figure. Consider a closed circular path of radius R which encloses the straight conductor carrying current I. The point P is at a perpendicular distance R from the conductor. Consider dl bar at a point P. Dl bar at a point P which is in FI direction. The tangential to the circular path at P is equal to dl bar is equal to R d phi FI. While S bar is obtained at P from Baryard-Savart's law, due to infinitely long conductor is S bar is equal to I divided by 2 pi R FI. If you substitute S bar dot dl bar, you get I by 2 pi d phi. Where fi bar is equal to 1, integrating S bar dl over the entire closed path, you get line integral of S bar dot dl bar is equal to fi is equal to 0 to 2 pi I by 2 pi d phi. Therefore, you will get S bar dot dl bar is equal to I. Lorentz force equation. We know that electric field intensity E bar is defined as the force per unit charge. E bar is equal to F bar by Q. Or Fe bar is equal to QE bar 1. Q is in coulomb, F is in Newton, E is volt per meter. So if a charge is in motion, then the force acting on it is given by equation number 1. Consider that the charged particle is moving in a magnetic field with flux density B bar. It is experimentally found that the force acting on such a charged particle is proportional to Q velocity V bar B bar into sin theta. Where V bar is velocity, theta is the angle between V bar and B bar. Therefore, Fm bar is given by Q magnitude of V bar and magnitude of B bar into sin theta is equal to Q inside bracket V bar curl of B bar. Now, the force on a moving particle due to combined electric and magnetic field is obtained by adding equation number 1 and 2. Therefore, F bar is equal to Fe bar plus Fm bar is given by given inside the bracket D bar plus V bar curl of B bar. This is called Lorentz force equation. So next one is Faraday's law. The electromagnetic force around a closed path is equal to the negative rate of change of magnetic flux enclosed by that path. Therefore, EMF is equal to minus D by dt F volt. Consider open circuited loop as shown in figure 2. Here let us assume that the gap is open circuited, loop is negligible. Therefore, EMF is equal to line integral of E bar dot dl bar, but phi is equal to B bar dot ds bar. Substitute 3 in 1, you will get EMF is equal to minus d by dt, integration of B bar dot ds bar is equal to integration of dou by dt B bar dot ds bar. Equation number 2 and 1, you will get E bar dot dl bar is equal to minus integration of dou by dou t ds bar. Equation 5 is called transform equation and also is Maxwell equation derived from Faraday's law. Next, derivation of boundary condition between two different dielectric. Let us consider two dielectric of permittivity epsilon 1 epsilon 2 and field is E1 E2 and where the conductivity sigma is equal to 0. This is the boundary between two, this one. And consider a rectangular box of A, B, C, D with length is equal to delta W and height is delta H. And consider a pill box with a cylindrical structure. Next, determination of tangential components. There is work done in our work done is equal to line integral of E bar dot dl bar. The work done around a closed loop is 0. Therefore, this rectangle is a closed loop. Therefore, we get work done is equal to 0. So, we will divide into different part. L, that is line integral of E bar dot dl bar is A to B, E bar dot dl bar, B to C, E bar dot dl bar, C to D, E bar dot dl bar, D to A, E bar dot dl bar is equal to 0. Let delta S tends to become very small, it tends to 0. Then you will get only then you will get b2c integration of e bar dot dl bar plus d2e integration of e bar dot dl bar is equal to 0. So only you will get a to b integration of a to b e bar dot dl bar plus c to d integration from e bar dot dl bar. This is equal to a to b e bar dot dl bar minus d to c, because c to d and d to c are opposite, they are writing negative here. E bar dot dl bar is equal to 0. Suppose you apply the limit, you will get e t2 delta w minus e t1 delta w is equal to 0. Therefore, you will get e t1 is equal to e t2. Two tangential components are equal. Similarly, determination of normal components, we know that by Gauss law, q is equal to d bar dot ds bar. Then we will divide the cylinder in three parts: top surface, side surface and bottom surface. For the top, you will get d bar dot ds bar, side surface d bar dot ds bar and bottom surface d bar dot ds bar. Let the height become 0, turn to 0. Then q is equal to, only you will get top surface area d bar dot ds bar plus bottom surface d bar dot ds bar. The side become 0. Therefore, we will not q is equal to, if you integrate and substitute the limit, we'll get dn to da dot ds minus dn1 bar dot ds is equal to q. Therefore, if you divide delta s throughout, we'll get dn2 minus dn1 is equal to rho s. Next, to find the boundary condition between the magnetic static field, here also you consider two magnetic material. One is having permeability mu1 and flux density B1, and also another is having permeability mu2 and flux density B2, and there are two media. Again, consider a rectangular box A, B, C, D, and also a cylindrical box with top surface, bottom surface and side surface. So to find tangential component, by Ampere's law we know that I is equal to line integral of S bar dot dl bar. Therefore, I is given by integration from A to B S bar dot dl bar and B to C S bar dot dl bar plus C to D S bar dot dl bar plus D to A S bar dot dl bar. If delta H is made very, very small, then it turns to 0. Therefore, I is given by integration from A to B S bar dot dl bar plus integration from C to D S bar dot dl bar. Therefore, I is equal to integration from A to B S bar dot dl bar minus integration from D to C S bar dot dl bar, because C to D, D to R, C are opposite to each other. Therefore, negative is written here. This is equal to HT, T2 delta W minus HT1 delta W. Therefore, you will get, divide delta W throughout, you will get HT2 minus HT1 is equal to I by delta W is equal to IS surface current. Therefore, tangential component of magnetic field HT2 minus HT1 is equal to surface current IS. Similarly, we can find the natural components. Here, we have to use Gauss law for magnetic field. Here, we will get, since the magnetic field lines are closed line, therefore, we will get B bar dot ds bar is equal to 0. This is one of the Gauss law of magnetic field, and this is given by top surface of cylinder B bar dot ds, bottom surface of cylinder B bar dot ds bar, and side surface of cylinder B bar dot ds bar is equal to 0. Let delta s is made very small, height is made very small, turn to 0. Then you get only the integration due to top surface and bottom surface. Therefore, if you apply the limit, you will get normal component Bn2 delta ds minus normal component Bn1 delta ds is equal to, therefore here Bn2 is equal to Bn1. Normal components are equal in the magnetic field. So there are four Maxwell equations. In point or differential form, we can write curl of E bar is equal to minus dou by dou t B bar, and curl of S bar is equal to J bar plus dou by dou t D bar, and divergence of D bar is equal to rho V, and fourth one is del dot B bar is equal to 0, where J bar is equal to sigma E bar. In free space, no charge, Del will get del cross E bar is equal to minus dou by dou t B bar, and curl of H bar is equal to dou by dou t D bar, and divergence of D bar is equal to 0, and fourth one is divergence of B bar is equal to 0. In integral form, the Maxwell's equation can be written as surface integral of D bar dot ds bar is equal to volume integral of rho v dv. Second one is line integral of E bar dot dl bar is equal to negative of surface integral of dou by dou t B bar dot ds bar. Third one is surface integral of B bar dot ds bar is equal to 0. And fourth one is surface integral of curl of S bar dot ds bar is equal to surface integral of J bar dot J bar plus dou by dou t D bar ds bar. So these are the four Maxwell equations. By using this, we can derive the expression for propagation of waves and also different characteristics of the waves in dielectric and conductor fields. So next lecture we will study the propagation of waves.